Smith with the ball. Fields wide over to Kluche. He'll power that big frame right in on Windy with a shot. He scores! Can't teach size or speed, but the Bandits really have it. They pushed it fast.
Yeah, and that might have been a wise decision because sometimes a bad shot in transition.
How about that finish of the transition? And that's Josh Byrne. And they'll try it again from the outside. Ball tipped by Dan Littner to the far side. Now back over to Sean Evans. He's twirling in, takes the diving shot. He scores!
Good loose ball by Weiss there to get Buffalo possession.
Dane Smith taking a shot. He scores! Dane Smith from the top of the slot, feeding it back over to a deking side of Josh Byrne. Here's Byrne with an air flight. Stopped by Windy. Oh, a ball trickles in. It scores! And they'll try it again from the outside. Ball tipped by Dan Littner to the far side. Now back over to Sean Evans. He's twirling in, takes the diving shot. He scores!
Ball by Weiss there to get Buffalo possession.
Dane Smith taking a shot. He scores! That's
in front of the net.
Bandits offense back down into the Knighthawks zone. Dane Smith, far side pass. Score! Ball is wheeled around. Quick stick shot. Score! Knighthawks, Turner Evans. And it's picked up by the Knighthawks, and they rush it right back. In over the line, Paul Dawson. There's a score by the Knighthawks off the stick.
Taking the feed, Dawson fed it out front. Three Bandits there, just none of them able to close out. And Cotone able to catch and shoot in quick transition. And the Knighthawks have a two-goal lead.
That's a first time tonight. Good heads up play, but Dave, thank you for the update. Here's second half action at KeyBank Center in Buffalo with the Bandits 7-4 lead. Knocking on the door of the Knighthawks, they score!
And that puts the Knighthawks within two. Very quick start for Rochester in the second half of this game.
Get Rochester goal scored by 19, Hogan Cotone.
Well, looks like Cotone gets his second one with under a minute in this second half and finding Twine and extra attackers trying to come back out from the bench. And a long drive score by the Knighthawksville Caputo.
Penalty coming up, was coming up to Buffalo for the hit from behind. And Caputo takes a step in over the restraining line, shoots high to low and manages to go five hole on Matt Vince. Ian McKay leaning over on a stick a little bit because he wanted to slide into the shooting lane, couldn't quite do it. And now you can hear the crowd a bit deflated, John, as the Bandits have given up three goals here. And a 7-3 lead is now evaporated.
Back over to Brown. Brown dekes his way in his big frame, gets a shot. Vince makes the save. Rebound picked up by the Bandits. However, it's busted up by the Knighthawks. They score!
Ball once again. Couple chances there at the restraining line for the Bandits to scoop a loose ball, and they don't. Gilray can't pick it up clean. And Turner Evans walks in and scores, and we're tied up at 7. And the Bandits certainly seem shaken since losing their captain, Steve Priolo. And we've got a new ball game here, 11 minutes to go in the third quarter, 7-7.
How about that? Buffalo building a shot that goes wide by the Cahawks. Ball picked up by Sean Evans. Left wing side, dashes in, has got some room to move. Just floats a pass out in front, score! And that's a trickly one.
Far. And we'll see if Buffalo can respond here. It looks like they're squeezing their sticks a bit on offense. They're scrambling a little bit on defense. And Rochester taking full advantage. And this five-goal run has given them a one-goal lead.
What a great play by Sean Evans to make that feather pass.
I think it was Caputo.
The rebound picked up by Matt Gilray, and he starts it up outside his own line and will move to mid. Right wing pass back over in front. There's a low drive, score!
The Bandits needed. First off, it was scooping a loose ball. They've struggled to scoop loose balls. Rochester actually found a loose ball on a rebound and got two chances on their offensive set, but a good scoop by Gilray. He earns himself the goal by scooping the loose ball in front of Matt Vince. So a good scoop of the loose ball in his own end, a good two-man gain up the floor between Sweeting and Gilray, and he makes no mistake. Steve Fryer upset.
Side, Smith along with Frazier. Far side is Byrne. Looking, there's a shot, score! What a great day!
because if they don't respect him, he's going to beat you. But instead, Dane Smith able to find that open space in front of the turf. Byrne just creates so much room because they defenders have to gravitate towards him. And you keep mentioning, John, what a pair these two have become. Seems like today it might be Byrne's turn to feed Dane a few goals.
Yep.
But for the Bandits, the biggest thing in all of that is they're back within one.
Steve, it seemed like he took advantage. You mentioned earlier how far out of the net Fryer played.
224 and counting. Knighthawks back down to the Bandit zone. Sean Evans looking, takes a shot, he scores!
Pick the far post here. Not much room to beat Matt Vince, but he finds it. He hits the inside of the post, it looks like. Not much room at all to shoot. Good defense by DeSnew. Good angle by Matt Vince. But a big goal by Sean Evans, and the Knighthawks back in the lead.
Second goal of the night for Evans. Fifth point of the night, and now we look at the milestone watch. He's one goal away now to pass Lewis Ratcliffe for 10th overall. And wait for that front door to open up and allow the forwards to come back out. Oh, Nice hangs on to the ball. Here's Nick Weiss with a shot. He scores! Weiss's pieces!
And gets right to that spot on the edge of the crease where he likes to quick stick from. And as Weiss starts to drive in, everyone in the building thought he might go to Corey Small. But instead, Steve Fryer comes out of the net and Weiss is able to go up and over his left shoulder. Big goal there by Nick Weiss to tie the game. But what a great job of using Corey Small there as a decoy to give himself some room to score a game-tying goal.
Well, the Bandits are right back into this one, and it took a matter of 30 seconds to do it. Dane Smith and now Nick Weiss, who dashes in, feeds it out to Cotone with a shot. That's blocked into traffic. Rebound. Knighthawks, they score! A hockey-style shot.
So Matt Vince makes a save. The ball ends up right in front of him, loose in front of the net. Three Bandits around it, and Curtis Knight's just happy to scoop and score because the loose ball was there. And the Bandits really struggling to scoop a loose ball in their own end. The Knighthawks continuing to get second and third opportunities. And any team in the
fresh 30, much needed here in the fourth.
It's a good break.
Down by two, far side pass to a deking Josh Byrne. Byrne back to Smith. There's a shot, score!
Before he even went to the net. Good ball movement here by the Bandits. A fortunate possession given to them by a procedural call. And Dane Smith finds Cloutier out front. He was able to fake near side, far side, near side, far side. And he tucks it around Steve Fryer. But still some work to do if you're Buffalo. A loose ball from Chris Cloutier.
5:56 and counting left in fourth quarter. Knighthawks by one, 13-12. Sean Evans with the ball, takes the shot, scores!
Backs him in, backs him in. There's Justin Martin. He just makes a couple of moves, turns and fires. Once again, not much room to shoot at. Justin Martin is in his pocket, but he turns and fires, beats Matt Vince. And Sean Evans leading this team, willing this team back to a two-goal lead with a single-handed effort.
There's a milestone for Sean Evans, 10th all-time, passes Lewis Ratcliffe. And that was hanging tonight, three goals away. He's got three goals and three assists along the boards. Good pursuit by the Kayhawks defensively by Frank Brown. Bandits from behind the net, 7 seconds left. A diving over the shoulder shot, score! How about that one by Chris Cloutier?
Held up right here, and then he holds up, swims over and goes the other way instead. Nothing Steve Fryer could do about that. What an athletic play by Chris Cloutier. He's single-handedly trying to keep the Bandits back in this game.
Good flight plan by Chris Cloutier to bring the Bandits within one with 4 minutes and 32 seconds left to play here in regulation. It's now with a break with the ball in over the line. Dane Smith, Deakey hangs onto the ball. Good positioning, score!
Last possession. This time Sean Evans was running over by the benches because Bryce Sweeting wouldn't let him get inside. So it was a four-on-four set. And the Bandits will take that because with Sean Evans removed, they're able to get down the floor. Dane Smith makes no mistake. One hand on the stick for the majority of that drive to the net, beating Steve Fryer, tied up with 3:52 to go.
Four goals, five assists tonight for number 92, Dane Smith. And we have a tie game. Training line of the Kayhawks in now. Smith in over the line, he goes with the ball, top of the slot, shot, score! Inspector Cloutier!
what players have done on offense. There's so many weapons, and they seem to be firing on all cylinders. A 15-goal night. You wondered who the play was going to be drawn up for. Clearly, Chris Cloutier, who catches it right in the high slot, takes one stride in and makes no mistake. Four goals for Cloutier. I believe that's three this quarter. So we talk about Sean Evans' efforts putting the Knighthawks back in this game and giving them the lead. Chris Cloutier showing up for Buffalo here in the fourth quarter, and we're tied.
7.1 seconds remaining in this regulation game. 15-15 the score. Four goals by Chris Cloutier. Cloutier outside the line to the near side, over to Smith, who gets it back to Cloutier, back to Smith. Here's Smith, quick stick shot, score! Pull the trigger, Curry Small.
First stick makes no mistake.
What about that shot, Corey Small? You just cannot stop that one. Quick stick, hot stick, you name it. The game-winning goal, again, to Corey Small. And the Bandits win it 16-15. What a game it has been for the Buffalo Bandits and Rochester Knights.